Hi Taurus, welcome to your October 2018 reading. My name is Ayushi and I'm from India. If you are new to the channel, welcome. And if you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for your support, guys. I know I've been away for a while now. I wasn't feeling well. So I stopped doing videos for 2-3 months. I hope you guys are good, and let's see what's coming up for Taurus. Taurus, you have a flipper here, which is Mother of Cups. So there is something emotional that is coming your way, or there is something which is making you very emotional, or there is a water sign around you, like a Pisces, I almost said Capricorn, but Cancer or Scorpio. That you are interested in, or they are interested in you. You could also be dealing with a person who is very selfless, and they understand your emotions better than most of the people, and they are providing you with something like a support. Or this is you acting the way like you are emotionally being supportive towards someone, is what I'm getting. You have six of wands here. So before I turned on the camera, you had six of wands reverse coming up, and right now also this card flipped in reverse almost. So I feel that there is some sort of recognition that you are waiting for. Like, you want to be recognized for your work, or you are being recognized for your work by the people around you, or you want to be recognized for your emotional strength, something of that sort. There is yes, here you are, the Hierophant, which is you, and six of swords, and the World card. So definitely there is some ending, closing of some chapters in your life. I'm also getting that there is something like a something conventional, something you do by the rules, by law, which is coming to you are moving away from that. You are trying to close a chapter which was legal, or which was institutionalized, like a family, marriage or something like that, or you are graduating, basically what I'm getting here. Some of you here are probably trying to move away from another Taurus person, and you, or this is you just moving away to calmer horizon, like a beautiful place, leaving all the darkness behind. And ending that chapter which was not serving you well, or something, after learning something, like something spiritual, gaining some spiritual insight, you are closing a chapter and starting a new one. This is the World card, the last card of the tarot deck. So you might be in touch with a spiritual community. What are the messages for Taurus? October 2018, Sun, Moon, Rising. Guys, please see that, take the messages that resonate with you and leave the rest. This is only a general reading, so not everything will resonate. Also, this is for Taurus, Sun, Moon and Rising for October 2018. What are the messages coming for Taurus, Sun, Moon, Rising, October 2018? This is a 10 card Celtic cross. Okay, before we begin that, okay, these are too many. 10 card Celtic cross for Taurus, October 2018. Let's begin. So, heart of the matter for you is the Seven of Pentacles. So Taurus, you are thinking about a project or an opportunity or something that you are working on. You are thinking if you should keep working on this project, because right now you are having doubts. You feel have I invested enough? Do I have more to invest in this? Am I investing at the right place? It can be a relationship or a work situation. You are you're analyzing the situation. You want to go step by step, and you want to not, like, you don't want to take any risky step. You want to know where you are going, and that's what you are trying to understand here right now. This can be you or someone else. What's crossing you is the Father of Wands. Now, there is someone here that you are dealing with who is very controlling, someone very, very bossy, someone who holds a lot of attention and charisma, but they are coming up as your challenge. So either you are not being bossy, or you are not taking full control, and that is why the situation is not working out for you, or you are being obstructed by someone who is like that, who is trying to be bossy and trying to tell you what to do. So probably that's what that is something that you're not liking, or there is a person who is hindering you, who is probably a Leo. I'm getting Scorpio or Sagittarius or Aries, who is interrupting in your work. They are trying to overpower you is what I'm getting here, and they can be hard to deal with because they can be very arrogant. Bottom of the reading is the Ten of Pentacles. So you are working towards making a lot of money. You want to start a family, or you want to build a home. You want to have you want to have your legacy in place, and you are working on its foundation. It can be something related to family in general. This is coming up in your past. So there was some recognition that came to you in past, like you were celebrated, or you were recognized for what you have done. You felt very liberated and independent, or you also felt very victorious in something in the past. Currently you are not liking something. You feel that there is not enough opportunity, or there is not enough for you. You want more. You want emotional fulfillment, basically. That's what I'm getting here. And I feel that either you are also thinking about the past, how things were in the past. Probably, like, you had a lot of you feel that whatever there was in the past was an ideal situation, and you want it back, but that is something you are missing right now is what I'm feeling. It's you, or you have offered someone something and they have rejected it, or somebody is offering you something and you are like, you are thinking about, does it suit me, is it good for me, is it enough for me, do I really, really want it? So you are rejecting it, or you are not appreciating the offer. In future, you have a major arcana, the Fool card, and you already have the World card, which was the last card of the tarot deck, where you were finishing a journey. Now here in future, you have to start a new journey from a scratch, from ground zero. This is a little, you know, bird which will take the leap of faith and start to develop its, you know, wings. It will learn to fly. So you have to take that leap of faith. You have to believe in yourself. You have to believe in your environment. You have to trust your environment. You have to go out there and take that risk initially, and then you will understand how things are placed, and that's how you will learn. So you will have to take some risk and just jump into something. How you come up in your reading is the Eight of Wands. Eight of Wands is about communication, back and forth communication, loving communication with someone. I think you are in communication with your family, like wife, father, parents, kids or something, some of you. Or you are traveling away from your family, or you are traveling towards your family, or some of you are thinking about that. What I am also getting here is that you are texting someone frequently, and there is a good conversation that is happening. It can be flirtatious, and you want to take your chances. the person that you are talking to probably, or someone outside of this situation that you are dealing with, is in two minds. Like, they are trying to make up their mind about something. They probably don't know where they have to go. They are not sure which path to take. So they are still considering. They are on the crossroad, and someone here is feeling the burden here. Like, I don't know if you are feeling the burden or this person is feeling the burden, but there is some burden that some of you are feeling because this decision is pending, because this person doesn't know where they are going or where they want to go. But they maybe it's about traveling. Even they want to travel, probably something related to travel for some of you. Now, this is regarding your fears. So you fear that there is something which is being hidden from you, or there is something which is not in your knowledge. So you don't know how to take that leap of faith, or how to approach someone, or how to take that jump, because you feel that there are things which are hidden from your knowledge, and you don't have complete grasp of the subject or where you are headed. So you are feeling that you need more information. You can be dealing with an Aries or a Pisces or a Earth sign. I'm also having here Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. Your outcome is that you will have to do research on the subject, which is Son of Swords. So either you are waiting for communication from somebody from outside, that they will tell you how, what decision that they have made, or you will do your own research and you will figure out what they are whatever information that you need. I think what you are trying to understand here is that what is actually being offered to you. And you feel like, should I be blunt about it? Should I ask this person if what they are what they are offering me is really what they are offering me? Like, you want to make sure what is being offered to you. So you are probably thinking about being blunt here, or someone around you is trying to gather more information, and they will probably stalk you for that information. Bottom of the deck here is the World card. So something is definitely coming in, coming to an end, and I'm getting that with that end you have to start something new, and it can be related to a love relationship. It is a soulmate connection, definitely. In fact, there is a possibility that someone will offer commitment here. Someone will offer to move in or take the relationship forward. They will offer to either get engaged or something like that, or you are moving in together with somebody. You are taking your action here with an Aries, or it can be Taurus or Scorpio or Aquarius as well, or a Leo. So that's what I'm getting here. Let me see, what is this Son of Swords about? What information is Taurus trying to gain by the end of the month of October? What is this information? Who is this stalker? What is this Son of Swords as the outcome for Taurus? Someone is looking for opportunity here to build something new from scratch. They want to build a solid foundation for a relationship, probably. Like, you want to offer somebody something, or somebody wants to offer you an opportunity to have a real connection, or something related to a new job. It's something new, basically, and you have to build it from the starting. Yes, you have to build something from the starting, and for some of you, it's up to you if you want to give somebody a second chance or not. So but if you give this person a second chance, you will have to forgive that person's previous flaws and everything, in order to start again from this scratch. You cannot just start from where you left, because I think the World card and the Fool here is saying that it needs to be a fresh start. You cannot start from where you had left off. In fact, the bottom of the deck here, the Magician, is the card number one. So you have the potential and the power to manifest whatever you want. You have all the resources and tools. You just have to put your mind and true intention and the right recipe to start something beautiful the way, exactly the way you want, because you have nine of cups below it, which is fulfillment and you know, desire fulfillment and satisfaction, emotional satisfaction. So that was your reading, Taurus, for October 2018. I hope you enjoyed the reading and I hope it resonated with it. If you did, kindly drop me a comment. I'll really appreciate it, and I hope to see you again. Bye bye.